3, 2, 1. All right, folks, Jonathan here, and my son is 3. All right, folks, Jonathan here, and at the moment my son is playing with his PlayStation. And what are you playing, mate? What is it?
Not telling. I'm underage.
No, he's not telling because he's underage. But it's lots of shooting. But anyway, there you go. Right, now, I've had quite a few emails. People have said, how do I plug a mixer into another mixer? In other words, you know, I want me mates around and we want to battle it out. And in other words, you know, you've got a set of decks over one side, you've got a set of decks over the other side, but you don't really want to have two PA systems, you just want to go into one. So how do you do it? Right, now I'll give you a bit of a demonstration, okay? First of all, you need two mixers. Secondly, most importantly, of course, you need four entities of music. When I say a minimum of four, I mean, ideally, if you think about it, if your mate's a DJ as well, then it's highly unlikely, unless, of course, they're saving up, it's highly unlikely they've only got one CD player or one turntable. Ideally, they've got two, you've got two mixers, so in other words, you've got three, so you've got six pieces of equipment. Bung them all together and you can have a right mess if you don't do it correctly. Now we'll take a look and I'll show you how to set it up. But first of all, we'll see where things need to be plugged in. And I'm sure if you think about it logically, it is quite logical. But sometimes it's that tiny little tip and it goes, that's how you do it. So we'll pause the camera and we'll have a look. Hold on. Right then, apart from a cup of tea and a tambourine, don't ask me why, we've got a mixer and two turntables there, and we've got another mixer and two turntables there. The only other thing, of course, you need is logically an amplifier and a speaker to make lots of nice noise with. Now, first things first, okay, you can see there, that is a two-channel mixer, okay? That one there is about a four-channel mixer, but put it this way, it's slightly more than two channels. Now then, first and foremost, importantly, you do need one mixer to be more than two channels. That's very important. Now, I'll explain why, quite logically. This mixer here, okay, this is the one that you will use as the beginning of your setup. Now, what I mean by the beginning of the setup is you've got that CDJ there plugged into there. Then that CDJ is plugged into there. Now then, there, that is your actual output. Now normally you would have that going directly to your amplifier or your powered speakers, but the difference is that goes straight across and that will go into the input of that CDJ over there. Okay, now that's quite important. Now also, just a little bit of logic here, if the setup is on that side of that mixer, then ideally you want the plug to go in on the same side. So in other words, if you think about it logically, this is quite logical, there's your one setup. Now imagine that was another turntable, okay? Now logically you would not have that turntable set on the other side of the mixer. You'd have it set on the side of the mixer associated with the side where your decks are. That's quite important because it just makes life easier. So what we're doing is we're going out of that output and we're going into, this is important, the line input or the CD input of that mixer. So there is the input from the other mixer. Then the next one is that CDJ there, and then the next one over there is that CDJ turntable. And then what I've done, I've gone from the output of that mixer into the back of the amplifier. All right, now we'll pause the camera and we're going to have a look at how to set the volumes, because that is just as important. Hold tight. Right, now then, whether this be in your bedroom or in a huge massive nightclub of 1,000 people, the principle will apply and it's exactly the same. Now then, this is the mixer that's plugged into the other mixer, and out of the other mixer we're going into the amplifier and the speakers. Now what you need to do, this is very, very important, you need to set both of these volumes to the max. Okay, this is important. You're probably thinking, now why on earth do we set both volumes to the maximum? But there's logic behind this. And also set bass, mid and treble just to 12 o'clock. And then your trim, logically what you would do with that. If I put this particular track on there now and we look at the trim, slowly it's going to increase until we get to sort of touching into the amber. Now we know now that if we go over too much like that, it's going to be distorted. So we want it clicking into the amber, like that. Now then, I'll show you why we need to do that. Okay, let's just... Okay, right, now we're on the other mixer. Now this is the mixer that we will go from this mixer directly into the actual amplifiers. Now as you can see, what I've done, I've set the level, the actual master output, to about 7/8. Now this channel here is the channel from the other mixer. Now then, this is where logic comes in, okay? If I was to set this, say there, and thought that should be fine, and then we plugged that mixer in and we started messing about with the actual levels on that mixer, for all we know, the output could be too high there, so what would happen is we would have some unknown output going into this channel, and all of a sudden, two things, it could be a lot louder than the two CDJs or the turntables on this side, and also it could be so loud, for all we know, it could go boom and blow half a dozen speakers, which you don't want to happen, not at all right? So, right, here's the deal now. There we are, we've set that, the actual master output. Now what we need to do is we need to press play on one of these guys over here. So we'll press play like that. Now bearing in mind now, that is the loudest that's going to go, unless of course the DJ starts turning the trim up too much. But if he does that, only one thing will happen. He'll think, or she'll think, yeah, wicked, we're getting a louder sound. Maybe you are. But eventually it'll be distorted and it'll sound absolutely atrocious. So what we need to do now, the phone's going, is we need to start turning this up. Now bearing in mind now, what's actually happening here is this now has, is even though it's one channel on this particular mixer, this now has become our master output for that mixer over there. So what we need to do as well, we need to make sure that the amplifier is set as loud as we want it to be set. And then by utilizing this and turning this up, say if we set it there. Right, I'm just going to pause that. Now, just imagine now that that was the loudest you wanted that CDJ mixer, etc., the mixer to go. That's the very loudest you wanted it to go. Now, the beauty about doing it this way, it means that near enough whatever happens over there, if all of a sudden, and we move back over here, if, let's say, the DJ now was playing at this volume, and it was relatively loud, and then as he moved the he or she moved the volumes up, it got louder and louder and louder, you know, because you've set the volume on the other mixer to the optimum level, you will know as soon as those volumes go as far as they can, it's not going to blow the speakers, it's not going to be too loud, because you've set the volume over that side. That's very important. And then all you need to do, if we then put the volume, sorry, put the press play again, I'm losing my words here. Right, I'll just turn the actual main amplifier down. Okay, now then, what we need to do now is we can press play here. So that's running, and then this is this side. Everything's wobbling, and then we'll press play on that one. There you go. Now you can see now, we've got a nice, decent sound, even though it's absolutely sounding terrible. There's beats all over the place. If we pause those, and we'll pause that now, at least by doing it this way, we know that the person on the other end of that mixer isn't going to knack at anything, because what you have to consider is this, all right? Let's say your mate's coming around and it's your PA system. You need to be in control of the master mixer. That's very important, okay? Exceedingly important. So there you go, folks. So basically, very simply again, what we've done is we've had the CDJ there going to that mixer, the CDJ there going to that mixer. We've had the output go from that mixer into this channel here. Now, it can go into any channel, all right? But ideally, because that mixer is that side, have it in the right-hand channel. If your mixer, the other one, was on the left-hand side over this side, then you'd have it into that channel. That's just logic. It just means it's easier for you to know which side the actual sort of channel is as such, so you don't mess around and you're not messing around with this side. And then, of course, you know then that these two are your channels to mess around with. And also, the beauty about it is, at the end of the day, if you're pissed off with the person and you don't like his mixing or her mixing, you can just do that. Right, now I'm going to have a bit of fun here, because I'm going to try and mix these four tracks, so this should be interesting. Hold tight.